guys back with another video. I'm doing college football today. My college basketball video got like 20 views, so I think you guys are liking my college sports videos. College football playoffs are coming up about here. I might do a video on my predictions on how it will be turning out after all those big games yesterday. A few upsets and stuff. But so here we go. We're getting the LSU Alabama game, and after this I'll do the Penn State Minnesota game. LSU beats number 2 Alabama 46-41. LSU moves to 9-0. Alabama moves to 8-1. If you're new to the channel, I'll talk about the players that stood out in this game. So here we go. And I'll pick a player of the game, and I'll do like notes and stuff on like what all this means and stuff. So that's pretty dang good. Holy crap. For 393 yards, almost 400. And he had 3 touchdowns and no receptions. What a game for him. He's been putting up numbers like this all the time, though. He's such a great passing QB. I wonder if he'll declare for the draft this year. I think he'll be a top draft pick if he does, especially if they go all the way through the college football playoffs. And he's got so many pieces around him that's really helping him. They've got Clyde Edwards, the running back, with 103 rushing yards and 3 touchdowns. He put a lot of points for this team. 3 touchdowns is very impressive. I didn't know he was that good until this game, but really came for him. Jamari Chase, 104 40 receiving yards from Joe Burrow and a touchdown. So that's most of his yards right there. Tua Tagovailoa, Alabama. He went 21-40, so a little bit over 50%. Not the best game for passing, except for he had 418 passing yards, and he passed an interception. I forgot to write on touchdowns for him, so I'm sorry. I don't know how many touchdowns he passed. I think a few at least. But Najee Harris had 146 rushing yards for Alabama and a touchdown. Good game for him. I wonder if he'll be a top pick in the draft. I wonder if he'll declare for it. And we had Devonta Smith, a really good wide receiver from Alabama, with 213 receiving yards and 2 touchdowns. Really good game for him. So now I'm going to narrow down to notes. I have a lot to talk about today. So Alabama's probably going to move down to the number 4 spot. Ohio State's probably going to move up to number 2. And Clemson move up to number 3 because those teams are both still undefeated, with Ohio State winning 73-14. Clemson winning 55-10. Since number 5 Penn State lost to Minnesota, Alabama will be number 5 still. And since Georgia also has a loss at number 6, they'll be good number 4, I think. That doesn't mean they can't move up, though. I think Alabama might make a push for winning all the rest of their games at the end of the year. LSU could easily be a number 1 or 2 seed in the college football playoffs, even with a loss. My reasoning is because you've seen them this whole season. I remember watching them when they were like 4-0 and 5-0. They're ranked like 13th or something. They're coming out of nowhere. And I just remember looking at how good they were at the passing game and how good Tripper was. After, and then they beat so many good teams. They beat Auburn. They beat all these good teams. I can make a video on how many good teams they beat this year. They're such a great team. One of the first games they beat Auburn, I'm pretty sure like the first game of the season. I can't remember. But there's an incredible team. Andrew Joe Burrow, I think, should easily be a Heisman contender. He could win it easily. Player of the game, then is going to Joe Burrow. What a game for him. I think he's a Heisman contender. Jonathan Taylor, too, could be one. I don't really have an idea. Everyone's probably two with Tagovailoa, too, even though he got injured. But that's a video. I'm going to go make a video on the Gophers, Penn State. Now, see you guys next video.